Hola, hola friends. Welcome back to another video here at A Life of Poetry. If you are new here, hello, my name is Kim. I am an author, illustrator, and here on my channel, I love to create videos about books and writing and just everyday lifestyle. So today, friends, today is a fun video. I really want to incorporate more into my channel, just fun and easygoing, relaxing, not too serious type of videos. And one of the things that I love to do, whether it's with my sisters or my mom or just by myself, is I love to go thrifting. I absolutely love thrifting. I really value buying secondhand. And as someone who really loves reading and loves collecting books and just having books around me, buying secondhand books for me is just a great way to still be able to do that, to be able to buy books, to be able to own books while also still staying within a budget. Because usually at thrift stores, books tend to be a lot cheaper than if you were to buy it just regular price. Also, my birthday was a few weeks ago. So I still have some gift cards that I want to use up, and I figured that going to the thrift store and finding some amazing little treasures, books, and other little trinkets is a great way for me to just spend these birthday gift cards. If you've seen my bookshelves before, which I've showcased here on my channel, you have seen all the little trinkets that I love having on my bookshelves. I love having my bookshelves with a nice little balance of just books and little treasures and trinkets. My bookshelves, I feel, kind of showcase the kind of reader I am and the kind of person I am. I love finding all these little trinkets at my local thrift stores. So today I figured that I would do a nice little hangout video, nice chill little video where we go thrifting. I am going thrifting with my sister, my mom, and my little niece. So it's gonna be a fun, good old time. They just opened a Savers near me as well. Before, I used to travel to Savers maybe like 30 minutes away from me, but now it's literally like 10 minutes. So I'm excited for that. I've already gone. I didn't film it, but I already went to go check it out. And you guys, it is full of treasures. Today's gonna be my second time going. Things that I'm looking for are, of course, books. I think Savers does like 4 books for X amount of money or something like that, or 5 books for X amount of money. I forgot what their little deal is. And I'm gonna look for little trinkets for my bookshelf. I also like to peep around the clothes as well. I love finding thrifty clothes. I think probably 80% of my wardrobe is thrifted, which I absolutely love. So we're gonna look at all the things and I'm gonna take you guys along. So I hope you guys have fun watching this video. Let me know if you guys want me to make more of these kinds of videos. Let me know down in the comments below. Also, stay towards the end of the video because I'm also going to be doing a haul of all the things that I found. So without any further ado, friends, let's go thrifting.
All right.
Are you ready to go thrifting?
Yeah.
All right.
I hope we don't fail to see.
All right, friends, we made it to Savers, and my mom and my sister couldn't come at the end, but I did bring my little niece, whose name is Alina.
Hi.
Say hi.
Hi.
She's my little niece. She's staying with us for the summer, and she came with me to the thrift store. So I'm looking for books and little trinkets for my bookshelves, and maybe some, I don't know, maybe I'll look at the clothes. But Alina, what are you looking for, girl? What are you looking for at the thrift store?
Paper dolls.
Paper dolls? We print those at the house.
No, I prefer paper dolls.
All right, friends, so we're going to go into Savers and we'll see what we find. Let's go.
There's so much more than we've been told, way beyond what we can hold. So keep your eyes open for the things that really matter. Oh, we have to give it one more try. Now that the idiots are taking over, they're caught up in the race of wanting more, and we can tell one from the other. What's it for? Oh no.
Such a fragile thing, I know. And with the winter comes the ice, the snow. But I'm here to hold. And oh my love, don't worry about the cold just yet. The trees haven't started to shed. Just feel the summer sun as it warms our bed. I'm lying, and I'm lying, say I'm not afraid, but I'm trying to shelter my love. The seasons come and they go, but I hope you know that I won't.
Found this for me?
Yeah.
Yeah?
No, that's for you because you say you a witch.
Oh.
You a
thank you.
back at my house. We had such a great time thrifting. After thrifting, we also went to Chick-fil-A because we were super hungry. Thrifting really does work up an appetite. So we had to get some food in our system, and that was very good. So as promised, I want to do a little haul of the things that I got from Savers. Now I will say I didn't find as much as I thought I would have found. I usually have really good thrifting days where I find way more than I actually wanted, but I suppose it was good that I didn't find that much because I only had a $40 budget, which was what I had in my gift card, and I also had a 20% coupon. So I suppose it was a good thing that I didn't find that many things because I initially wanted to stay within a budget, which I did, so that worked out. I'm gonna start off with the little trinkets that I found. I absolutely love trinkets. I love decorating my bookshelves and my space with just little whimsical trinkets, and I found two little trinkets that I just couldn't leave behind. So if you know me, you know that I'm a huge fan of everything that has to do with butterflies. I love, love, love butterflies. I have a butterfly back here in my collage wall, and I found actually another little butterfly frame that I just thought was so cute. I loved the color of the butterfly. And then I don't know if you guys could see that, but the text says, "Believe in yourself," and it was only $2.99. I actually found another one that looked exactly like this, but the color of the butterfly was a little bit different, but I didn't really like the color of the butterfly, so I ended up just getting this one, and it's a little hanging frame. You can see the little hanging thing here, but I think I'm just gonna have this stand up on one of my bookshelves. I really love the contrast of this black and blue butterfly against the contrast of this gold frame. I just think it looks so pretty, so whimsical. So I was so excited when I seen this. The next little trinket that I found that I just could not leave behind is actually my future dream home. And that is this little thing right here. You guys, look at this cute little cottage house. Oh my goodness, this is the cutest little just statue. If you guys didn't know, I actually have a fascination with houses. I actually want to get into collecting houses, and this is just such a cute little cottage that I found. It just reminded me of The Hobbit, and I was like, oh my gosh, that looks like something from The Hobbit, and I want to live in this cute little cottage. I could have just already pictured just a stack of books and this on top of it. It's gonna look so cute, and it's just gonna be so magical. I cannot wait. And the little cottage was only $2.99, by the way. And the last little trinket-ish thing that I got was this big candle. I love big candles like this. I've been needing some candles. The only candle that I have is all wonky already. I'm glad I found this, and this was, I think, only like $2. It is a little bit scraped and not in the best condition, but I mean, for $2, I'm fine. And it still kind of smells, which is nice. But also I have some candle oil that I could just drop on there, and it'll revive the smell. All right, so those were the only trinkets that I got. Now moving on to some apparel items that I did find. So usually I have really good luck with finding apparel at thrift stores, but this time around, I don't know if I just wasn't into it. I ended up leaving looking for apparel towards the very end once we were almost getting ready to leave. And I think at this point I was just kind of over it. I was already hungry. So I just quickly looked through some stuff. I picked some stuff up, but I ended up leaving most of it behind. But the two things that I did end up just bringing with me, because I was just like, oh, these are kind of cute, is actually this shirt right here. And it says, "Read books, see art, listen to music," which are all things that I love doing. I almost left this behind because it was $7.99, but everything that was tagged green was actually 50% off, so I ended up just taking this. I think this is gonna be a great little basic on days when I don't wanna really get dressed. And so I just throw this on, and I have a cool little quote on here, and I don't know, still interesting. So that was the only shirt that I got. And the last apparel item that I got was actually this hat that says "Bad Hair Day." Now, I used to be someone that did not wear any hats, but lately, you guys, all I want to do is just wear cap. I am on my girly cap era. I used to be very self-conscious because I have a chubby face, which is fine. I love my round cheeks. I love everything about my face, but I used to be very self-conscious about just putting hats on for me when I looked in the mirror. I don't know, I just felt very self-conscious. And for a majority of my life, I've struggled with body dysmorphia. So I am in a space in my life the last few years where I'm just trying new things. I'm trying to feel more comfortable in my body and just trying different clothes on and seeing what I feel comfortable comfortable and what I feel beautiful in. And just lately, I've just been getting a very severe pull towards just wearing caps, and I have been wearing caps for like the last month, and I have been loving it, and I feel like it's just great during the summer season. So I ended up getting this little cap that says bad hair day, and I feel like it's just gonna be great on those actually bad hair days. I am loving it. All right, but I don't think today I'm having a bad hair day. Actually, I really like how my hair's looking right now. So we're gonna put this away for now. Now moving on to the books. So Savers always has this thing where it is you buy 4 books and you get the 5th one free, which I really love. So I ended up getting 5 books in total. So the first book that I got, my niece actually found it for me. It was actually so hilarious when she gave this to me. And that is These Witches Don't Burn by Isabel Sterling. I have never heard of this book, but my little niece was just like, she handed this book to me and she's all like, you're always saying that you're a witch, so I think that you should take this book. And I was just cracking up at the store because I always tell her that I'm a witch. So she said that I should get this book. So she said that I should get this book, and I did. It actually sounds kind of interesting, and I'm never gonna turn a witchy book down, so I obviously had to pick it up, and it was only $3.99, you guys. So the synopsis says, Hannah's a witch, but not the kind you're thinking of. She's a real deal, an elemental with the power to control fire, earth, water, and air. But even though she lives in Salem, Massachusetts, her magic is a secret she has to keep to herself. If she's caught using it in front of a reg, which is a non-witch, she could lose it for good. So Hannah spends most of her time avoiding her ex-girlfriend and fellow elemental witch, Veronica, hanging out with her best friend and working at the fly-by-night cauldron, selling candles and crystals to tourists, goths, and local Wiccans. But dealing with her ex is the least of Hannah's concerns when evidence of dark magic begins to appear all over Salem. Hannah's sure it's the work of a deadly blood witch, but her coven is less than convinced. So Hannah is forced to team up with the last person she wants to see, Veronica. And while the pair attempt to smoke out the blood witch, Hannah meets Morgan, a cute new ballerina in town. Trying to date amid a supernatural crisis is easier said than done, especially when the attacks of Salem's witches become deadlier by the day. Now with everything she loves on the line, Hannah must confront this murderous villain before her coven, and any chance she has with the new girl is destroyed. This sounds so good, you guys, and I also really love that this is a queer novel. That's gonna be very exciting. The next book that I got is actually in middle grade, and this is The Storm Runner by J.C. Cervantes. J.C. Cervantes is a Latine author, and I'm a huge fan of their works, so I was very excited when I found this, and it's actually in pretty good condition. It was only $3.99. So the synopsis says, Saint Obispo spends every day exploring the sleeping volcano in his backyard. The Beast, as he calls it, is the one place where he can escape other kids who make fun of him because he has a limp and walks with a cane. After a twin engine plane crashes into the Beast, a mysterious girl named Brooks shows up at Zane's doorstep, insisting that they meet at the volcano where she will reveal a terrible secret. Zane agrees, mostly because beautiful girls like her don't usually talk to him. Brooks tells him that the volcano is actually a centuries-old prison for the Maya god of death, whose destiny is directly tied to Zane's. No way, Zane thinks. He's just a 13-year-old nobody, and destiny or no destiny, he wants nothing to do with any of it, especially some god of death. But Brooks opens his eyes to the truth. Magic, monsters, and gods are real, and Zane is at the center of an ancient prophecy that could mean the destruction of the world. Suddenly finding himself entangled in a web of dangerous secrets, Zane embarks on a quest that will take him far from home and test him to the very core. Feisty heroes, tricky gods, murderous demons, and spirited giants are just some of the pleasures that await in this fresh and funny take on Maya mythology, as rich and delicious as a mug of authentic hot chocolate. Ooh, I love that. I absolutely adore cultural mythology. I think any mythology from any culture is just so cool to read in a sort of retelling. Oh, I just eat those type of stories up. I love them. So I'm excited for this one. The next book that I found is actually a graphic novel. This is a graphic novel that I've always see everywhere, and I've been wanting to get into this particular series. So I'm excited that I found the first book. I believe there's like, oh my gosh, there's like so many, I think, in this series. But luckily, I found the first book in the series at the thrift store. I think they also had some other ones, but they were like number 5 and like 6 in the series. And I was like, I'm not gonna read those anytime soon. Not until I read them, obviously, in order. So I ended up leaving those behind, and I got the first one in that series. And that is Amulet, The Stone Keeper. This is book 1 by Kazu Kibuishi. I've always seen these and I've always wanted to pick them up. And the synopsis says, there's something strange behind the basement door. After a family tragedy, Emily, Navin, and their mother moved to an ancestral home to start a new life. On the family's very first night in the mysterious house, Em and Navin's mom is kidnapped by a tentacled creature. Now it's up to Em and Navin to figure out how to set things right and save their mother's life. This sounds like a really cool adventure. I love the illustrations inside. Look at those. They just look like a good time, you guys. I'm excited to read this story and hopefully collect the rest of the books later on. The next book that I got is actually by one of my favorite authors, and that is The Daughter of Dr. Maru by Silvia Moreno Garcia. I actually have a couple of Silvia Moreno Garcia books. I have Mexican Gothic and what is it? The other one that's based on Aztec mythology. I believe the Gods of Jade and something. I remember reading somewhere a while ago that this is sort of like Bridgerton. So if you like Bridgerton, then you might also enjoy this. And this is by a Latina author. And the synopsis says, Carlota Maru, a young woman growing up on a remote and luxuriant estate, safe from the conflict and strife of the Yucatan Peninsula, the only daughter of a researcher who is either a genius or a madman. Montgomery Lofton, a melancholic overseer with a tragic past and a propensity for alcohol, an outcast who assists Carlota's father with experiments which are financed by the Lizaldes, owners of the magnificent haciendas and plentiful coffers. The hybrids, the fruits of the doctor's labor, destined to blindly obey their creator and remain in the shadows, a motley group of part human, part animal monstrosities. All of them live in a perfectly balanced and static world which is jolted by the abrupt arrival of Eduardo Lizalde, the charming and careless son of Dr. Mario's patron, who will unwittingly begin a dangerous chain reaction. For Mario keeps secrets, Carlota has questions, and in the sweltering heat of the jungle, passions may ignite. The Daughter of Dr. Mario is both a dazzling historical novel and a daring science fiction journey. And then the little blurb on here says, from the author of Mexican Gothic and Velvet Was the Night comes a dreamy reimagining of H.G. Wells, the island of Dr. Maru, set against the backdrop of 19th century Mexico. I really love that Silvia Moreno Garcia just bases many of the novels that she writes in older time Mexico. I don't feel like I read that many books where the setting is Mexico, but back in the day, usually when they are based in Mexico, it's like way, way back in the day. But Silvia Moreno Garcia does a really beautiful job in incorporating like 19th century, 18th century Mexico, and it's just so beautiful to read a story based in a setting like that, and I really enjoy that. Now the last book that I got, I actually was really surprised that I found this. It is in such great state and it's also a hardcover. I've been meaning to pick this book up for some time now and I really want to get into this series. This is book one in the series, and that is Children of Blood and Bone by Tommy Adeyemi. You guys, this is a hardcover and it's in great condition. There's like no rips, no nothing. It's just so beautiful. And this was only $5.99, you guys. We love a map. It has a beautiful map on the inside. Love that. I actually recommended this book in one of my videos a while ago about fantasy books you should read that are written by POC authors. So this was one of them. And I am so happy that I finally have a physical copy of this book. I don't know if this is a trilogy or this only has a prequel, but it's something like that. So the synopsis of this book says, Zeli Abedola remembers when the soil of Orisha hummed with magic. Burners ignited flames, titers beckoned waves, and Zeli's reaper mother summoned forth souls. But everything changed once magic disappeared under the orders of a ruthless king. The Magi were targeted and killed, leaving Zeli without a mother and her people without hope. Now Zeli has one chance to bring back magic and strike against the monarchy. With the help of a rogue princess, Zeli must outwit and outrun the crown prince, who is hell-bent on eradicating magic for good. Danger lurks in Orisha, where snow leopardies prowl and vengeful spirits wait in the waters. Yet the greatest threat may be Zeli herself, as she struggles to control her powers and her growing feelings for an enemy. You guys, I am pretty sure I'm gonna eat this story up. It just sounds something like so up my alley. Orisha's magic. I love it. I love it. And you guys, in total, I just spent $37.26. $37.26 is what I spent. And I actually also purchased a little doll for my niece, and she also got a Junie B. Jones book. So I would say that we did pretty good today. So friends, those were all my finds for this thrifting vlog. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. I really want to focus on just making fun and no pressure type of content. Nothing that has to be aesthetically pleasing or just perfectly curated. I feel like this will reignite that love that I once felt for just creating content, any type of content in general, because if you've seen my last couple of videos, you know that I have been mentally struggling with just finding that balance with doing this as something that I want to pursue as, yes, a job that can sustain me, but just also something that I can do just to have fun. So I really want to find that balance for myself, and I feel like incorporating these kind of videos, more just no pressure type of content, low energy type of content, that will really help balance those, what I've been feeling lately. So let me know if you would enjoy more content like this. Let me know down in the comments below. That way I can also prioritize this kind of content for you guys. Yeah, I would very much appreciate your feedback on that. Also, let me know down in the comments below what your favorite thing was that I purchased. With that being said, friends, I really hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please remember to like, subscribe, engage with my videos. That would really help me out a lot. And I'm on a journey to hopefully reaching 5,000 subscribers. That's my next goal. So your engagement will really help out my videos. Remember, friends, that you can create the life that you want because you so deserve it, friend. I will be seeing you in a video very, very soon. Take care and bye for now.